legs, shoulders moving a little bit. The arms swing forward and backwards gently. And then do some beating the heavenly drums. Settle down, and swinging forwards and backwards. Slowly let the arms settle all the way down. Pop the hands on the hips and circling the hips. And then go around the other way. Lift, circle the legs out to the side. And then kick the heels up to the hands. And then pop the feet shoulder width apart and reach down towards your feet on the floor. Relax the head. And slowly, slowly come up. Give the arms and legs a good shake. So we're going to have a nice relaxing start to the week. This week we're going to start with a meditation exercise. So have the feet shoulder width apart, toes facing forward, arms relaxed to the side. Straighten but don't lock your knees. And tuck the chin in slightly. You can check with the right position, because if you run your hands up and down the back of your neck, it should feel flat rather than having that normal curve outwards. Just check your neck, put the chin in. Feel like you're being lifted up from the crown. If you're wondering where your crown is, if you put your fingers on the top of each ear and run your fingers straight up the top of your head where they meet, that's the point where you're being picked up from. So we're focusing not on our feet but on lifting from the top of the head. The weight it's going through the feet, it's going a little bit more through the balls of the feet than the heels. You want to feel like your feet are quite light on the floor though. And here we're focusing on lengthening and straightening the spine by being pulled upwards. is straightening between the shoulder blades, all down to the lower back. And a little bit like if you were to pick a hoodie up off the floor, from the very top of the hood, the arms, everything would kind of settle down into the right position. Have that feeling here, like you're lifting from the peak, from the top of the head. Everything else just kind of falls into alignment. Once the spine's straight, then the shoulders can relax. If the spine's out of alignment, then you're going to tense up one side or the other, or both sides. When you're using your spine to hold you upwards, and using the top of the head to hold the spine up, the musculoskeletal system can settle down into the correct position. So feel like the shoulders are relaxed, arms hanging heavy by your side, or just slightly in front of you. Another area where we hold tension is in our hips, pelvis area, glutes. So try to not feel like your weight is sinking down, so that area of the body doesn't need to feel heavy or like it's taking your weight. You feel light. Feel like you have a lightness in the thighs. A softness in the knees and the ankles. Few seconds left in this position, but the feeling is that you want to feel like you're a little bit taller and a bit more relaxed than when you started. So the next position, focusing is again on the spine stretching upwards from the crown, but now the spine stretching downwards from the base of the spine. So we put our feet together or nearly together, and again having the weight a bit more through the balls of the feet than the heels, and bend your knees, but it really it's just a softening of the stance, not really bending your knees so your whole body tenses up. So bend the knees to soften the stance. And when you bend your knees, have a feeling that the knees are bending and the hips are relaxing. And when the knees bend and the hips relax, then the pelvis can settle down. When the pelvis settles down, you'll feel like the weight sinking quite heavily through the balls of the feet. And by the pelvis settling down, pulls the tailbone, or the tailbone settles down, pulls the lower spine downwards, so you're stretching down from the bottom of the spine, still with that connection up, lifting up from the top of the spine. So it's a subtle internal stretch of the spine. If you can't yet feel it, which does take a bit of practice, first of all, imagine it. Imagine the sensation, imagine the feeling of the spine gently stretching up, gently stretching down. Still with the chin tucked in slightly, arms by your side, the chest slightly sunk, shoulders very slightly rounded forwards. There's no specific pattern of breathing, just relax your breath. Because the feet are a bit closer together. This one's a bit trickier on the balance, so you really have to find your center line, find your spine, find your balance. If that's a bit difficult with your eyes closed, then you can open or half open your eyes for this one. You start to feel like the thighs are quite heavy. First of all, refocus on lift from the top of the head. Now, Tai Chi practice, we sink down, we root ourselves to the ground, we relax downwards, but never lose the lift from the top of the head. This is yin and yang in practice. Your yin energy sinks down, your yang energy lifts up. Next one, we've got our feet back to shoulder width. Here we have the knees bent. And when you bend your knees here, you want to just slightly roll your, tilt your pelvis back. So your tailbone's pointing down. So if you run your hands up and down your lower back, it should feel flat. The neck should feel flat because you're tucking your chin in, lifting from the top of the head. So your spine all the way up, all the way down is one straight line. We bring, have the knees slightly bent, weight through the balls of the feet, and bring the hands in front of you like this. So the palms just in front of your dantian, your energy center, just a little bit below the belly button. And the palms are slightly rounded, and you're pressing like you're pressing two balls downwards. Chin tucked in, leads from the top of the head. Shoulders, again, shoulders a little bit forward because the chest sunk and the upper back is slightly rounded. And here we're focusing on, again, lifting up from the top of the head, lower body sinking down. So the lower body feels heavy, sinking down. Upper body feels light and lifting up. The middle of the body feels mobile and flexible. But here it's not just from the feet we're sinking down, it's also like we're pressing the palms downwards as well. So palms sinking down, feet sinking down. Relax the hips and the pelvis sinks down. So you have a very strong base from the palms, the soles of the feet, and the pelvis, the tailbone, or sinking, pulling you down. But the top of the head lifts up, so it's like a pyramid, one point at the top, and then a solid wide base at the bottom. Feel like any part of the body is getting a little bit too tense, maybe the shoulders or the arms or the hips, just give them a little bit of a shake. You don't have to stay completely static all the way through. You can shake your legs, you can shake your arms, you can shake your shoulders. That's it, loose enough, and then settle back down. Better to do that than to feel like you're getting very rigid in a position. You still want everything to feel very light, very flexible, very mobile. The next movement, keep your hands in this position, come up, straighten the legs, or very very close to straightening the legs, not fully locked out, lift the hands up to the shoulders, sorry, get my anatomy right, lift the hands up just below the chest, and then bend the knees, sink the hands down, back down in front of your dantian, and then you're coming up again, lifting slowly, and then sinking down, so a little bit of movement, not much movement there, or not much external movement. Breathe in as you lift, breathe out as you sink down. When you lift, feel like the top of the head, piece of string from the crown is pulling you upwards. When you sit down, relax the ankles, knees, hips and the hands and drift back down towards the ground. So you're being pulled upwards and then relaxing downwards. to lift, breathe out, sink down. Palms, the hands and soles of the feet, as you lift, you feel very light and then heavy as you sink down. Feel very empty as you lift, more full as you sink down. Down again, bend your knees. Final position, bring the arms up and around. So they circle in front of you. So from the lower body, we're settling down. Sink through the balls of the feet, backs, ankles, the knees. Again, remember to roll the pelvis back slightly so the tailbone is pointing down. Relax the hips, let the pelvis settle down. Chest slightly sunk, shoulder blades slightly rounded. Chin tucked in, top of the head lifting up. And then the arms are circular. Fingers pointing towards each other, don't let them dip down. And feel as though the fingers and the top of the head are lifting up, holding you up. Everything else is settling and sinking down. So it's the elbow sinks down. When the elbow sinks down, just pulls the shoulder down, pulls the arm downwards. So it's a good exercise. If you find that when you hold your arms up, your shoulder also comes up, this is a good exercise to correct that. And then focus on all of the basics we've been going through. Focus on the bone structure of the body holding you in place. Structure of the body is holding in place, the soft tissue is sinking and relaxing. So the muscles relax, tendons, ligaments, all the connective tissues. The bones are very stable. So the muscles, tendons, ligaments, all hanging off the bone almost. Shake your body if you start to tense up anywhere, and then settle back down. That two-way connection, heads, fingers leading up, everything else settling down through the balls of the feet. Slowly bring the arms down and three circular breaths to finish off. Breathing in to lift, breathe out, sit down. Steps in, and we're all done. Thank you very much. Have a good day.